for watching this video. It is going to be of real benefit to you because you are going to learn a Spark method of addition. That means you will be able to do additions quickly, very fast. Now, this is a method called Vilokanam, and it means by observation. That means we are doing addition by observation, observing the digits. We do the addition, and this is called Spark method because this is done very quickly. And another thing is that it is done from left to right. You know, our mind is programmed and to work from left to right better. So this method will work better for you. Now, in this method, we have to be conversant with two concepts. One of it is carry or the non-carry number. And the second concept we need to know is end numbers. When we know these both concepts, we will be able to do the addition very quickly. Now, what are carry or non-carry numbers? Now look, the combinations of numbers which form the sum 10 or more than 10 are known as carry numbers. That means this combination is making 10. This means this combination is a carry number. These are carry numbers. This is a carry number. This makes 10. This is a carry number. Now 3 plus 7 is 10. This makes a carry number, carry combination. So we have to know which combination is a carry combination and which is a non-carry combination. So if the sum is n or more than 10, it is a carry combination. And if the sum is less than 10, it is a non-carry combination. 4 plus 8 is 12. So is it a carry or non-carry? It is a carry combination. 1 plus 6, what is it? Carry or non-carry? This is less than 10, so this is a non-carry combination. 5 plus 3 is 8. This is a non-carry combination because it is less than 10. 7 plus 5 is 12. It is a carry combination because it is more than 10. 9 plus 3 is 12 again. It is a carry combination because it is more than 10. 2 plus 6 is 8. This is a non-carry combination because it is less than 10. I hope you have understood what is a carry combination or what is a non-carry combination. Now let us learn what do we mean by end numbers. Now supposing we have a number 12. In number 12, the unit digit is 2. This is the end number. In 17, 7 is the end number. In 14, 4 is the end number. In 10, 0 is the 10 number. In 4, because it is only a unit digit, it is a 10 end number. In 16, 6 is the end number. In 7, 7 is the end number. So I hope you can understand all the digits which are at the unit's place are the end numbers. So with this concept in mind, let's move further and learn how to do addition by observation method. Now here we have to add 43 to 29. Now we start from left to right. So first we will add 4 and 2. That makes 6. But before writing 6, we have to observe the next combination. The next combination is 9 and 3. And this combination is a carry combination. So when we have a carry combination, we have to add 1 to the previous combination, like 4 plus 2 is 6, but I will not write 6, I will write 7, and 9 plus 3 is 12, but only the end number I have to write, that means 2. So 43 plus 29 is 2. I hope you have understood. You must have started understanding. So we will do many more sums, and I'm sure you'll be perfect in it. Now let's see the next one. 2 + 4 = 6. But before writing 6, I will see the next combination. Six plus three is a non-carry combination because it is at the end. 6 + 3 = 9. It is a non-carry combination. So 2 + 4 = 6. And because next one is a non-carry combination, I will write 6 over here, and 6 + 3 = 9. Now, 8 + 5 = 13. Before writing 13, I will see the next combination. It is a non-carry combination, so I will write 13, and 4 + 2 = 6. Now, 6 + 7 = 13. But before writing 13, I will see the next combination is a carry combination. So instead of writing 13, I will write 14. Now 8 + 6 = 14. That means the end number only, that is 4. Now, when we have suppose 3 digits adding to 2 digits, we can take these first 2 digits together. Now 24 + 3 = 27, but when I see the next combination, 3 + 9 is a carry combination. So instead of 27, I will write 28. And 9 + 3 = 12, means 2 and a number. Here I will write only the end number. Only in the first, you have to write the complete number. Later on, for all the digits combination, you only have to write the end number. So let's see. 14 + 5 = 19, and next is a non-carry combination. So I will write 19 only, and 4 + 3 = 7. Now 75 + 8 = 83, but I will write 84 because next is a carry combination. So 6 + 5 = 11 means end a number only one. So 841. Let's move to the 3-digit additions. Now here, 2 + 3 = 5. But before writing 5, I will see the next combination is a non-carry combination. So I will write 5 over here. Now 4 + 3 = 7, but before writing 7, I will write, see the next combination, which is a carry combination. So instead of writing 7, I will write 7 + 1, that is 8. And now 7 + 3 = 10, so 0, the end number only. Now again, 1 + 2 = 3, but before I write 3, I see that the next is a non-carry combination, so I write 3. Now 2 + 4 = 6, but next one is a carry combination, so instead of writing 6, I will write 7, and 8 + 7 = 15, end number, I will write only 5. Now here, 7 + 8 = 15, but because 8 + 6 is a carry combination, so instead of writing 15, I will write 15 + 1, that is 16. Now 8 + 6 = 14, that means end the number 4, but before writing 4, I will observe the next combination. Because it is a non-carry combination, I will not add 1 to 4, I will write only 4 over here, and 4 + 4 = 8. Now let's move further, take some more sums. Again, 3 digits added to 2 digits. When we have such a combination, 3-digit adding to 2 digits, we take these first 2 digits together. So 74 + 3 = 77, but because next combination is a carry one, instead of 77, I will write 78, and 9 plus 4 is 13 and number 3. 54 plus 4 is 58, but next is a carry combination. So I will write 58 plus 1, 59, and 8 plus 2 is 10, only the end number 0. 73 plus 2 is 75, and next is a non-carry. So I will write only 75, and 6 plus 3 is 9. I hope you are understanding. Let's move further. I want to explain to you, we have to take care when the combination is of 9. When the two numbers make the combination 9, then we are not very sure whether it is a carry number or a non-carry number. A combination of 9 means if we have a combination of 0 plus 9, it is a combination of 9. 1 plus 8 is also a combination of 9. 2 and 7 is a combination of 9. 3 and 6 is a combination of 9. 4 and 5 is a combination of 9. I mean, whenever two numbers, they are adding up to 9, they make a combination of 9. And when we have such a case in our numbers, which we have to add, we have to be very observant. Before writing, we have to see the next combination also. Because when we are getting 9 as the sum, as an end number, we are not very sure to write it as 9. Because unless we see the next combination, if the next combination is a carry number, this will be also a carry number. If next will be a non-carry number, this combination will also be a non-carry number. Maybe you are not understanding now, but when we do, you will understand it. Now look, here we have 3 plus 2, that will make 5. That this makes 5. And we know that next is a non-carry otherwise, but I told you to take special care when you have a combination of 9. So when we have a combination of 9, like in this case, we have a combination of 9. So 3 plus 2 otherwise is 5. And this is a non-carry according to us. But when we have a combination of 9, we have to see the next combination. We have to see the next combination. If this combination is carry, this is also a carry. And so we will add the number here. Instead of writing 5, we will need to write 6 over here. And 5 plus 4 is 9. But then we need to write, because this is a carry number, we'll write 0 over here. And 8 plus 3 is 11, so the end number 1, 601. I hope you have understood, because when we have a combination of 9, we are not sure whether this will be carry or non-carry unless we see the next combination. If the next combination is carry, this will also be a carry. If the next combination is non-carry, the previous one, which is making a combination of 9, would also be non-carry. So we will do accordingly. This you have to be very particular when you are dealing with the numbers which combine to form 9. But if these combinations are in the beginning, like in this case, it is in the beginning, then you don't have to worry. If the combination is at the end, then also you only have to write whatever end number you get. But if it is in between, you have to be very particular. And before writing, you have to see the combination next to those two digits, which are making the combination of 9. Now let's see. 7 plus 2 is 9. Because it is the first number only, we will write 9 only, because next is a non-carry. So I will write 9 over here. 4 plus 2 is 6. And next one is also a non-carry. So I will write 6. And 5 plus 3 is 8. So I write 8 over here. Now let's see this one. Here, 5 plus 3 is 8. And next is a non-carry. So I will write 8. 4 plus 2 is 6, And next one is 9, but this is the last one, so I don't have to worry. This last combination of 9 will be non-carry only. So 4 plus 2 is 6, so I will write 6 only. And 7 plus 2 is 9, so 869, this will be our answer. Now let's see this one. Now here in the beginning, we have a combination of 9. So beginning 9, we will just write like that, 9. Now the next combination is also 9, and this is in between. So we have to take care whether the last one, which is coming after it, is carry or non-carry. Now because this is a last combination, it will be a non-carry. So this one will be a non-carry also. So 7 plus 2, 9, and we will write 9 only. And now 4 plus 5 is 9. So I will write 9 because it is a non-carry now. 8 plus 1 is also 9. So we have 999. Now let's see this one. 374 added to 929. Now here 9 plus 3 is 12. 9 plus 3 is 12, but the next combination is of 9. I can't be sure whether this is a carry or a non-carry. So before I am sure, I have to see the next combination. Now this combination of 4 plus 9 is a carry combination. So this one also is a carry combination. So instead of writing 12, I write 13. And then because 7 plus 2 is 9, but next to it would be 10. So the end number we will write 0. And 9 plus 4 is 13, means end number 3. So our answer is 1303. I hope you are understanding this. Now let's take a number bigger, 4-digit number, adding to 4-digit number. So first of all, 5 plus 3 is 8, but I see the next combination is non-carry, so I will write 8. Now 2 plus 2 is 4, and the next combination is non-carry, so I will write 4. Now 4 plus 2 is 6, and because the last one, 9, is a non-carry, so 4 plus 2 is 6, I will write 6, and 6 plus 3 is 9. Now this one, 7 plus 2 is 9, because it is in the beginning only, and the next is a non-carry, we will write 9. Now 3 plus 3 is 6, but the next one is a carry combination, so instead of writing 6, I will write 7. Now 4 plus 9 is 13, and the number is 3, but before writing 3, I see that the next combination is a carry, so instead of writing 3, I will write 3 plus 1, that is 4. And the last one, 8 plus 6 is 14, and number 14. So 7,348 plus 2,396 makes 9,744. And let's do this sum now. This is a 5-digit sum. So let's learn how to do. 7 plus 5 is 12. Before writing 12, I see the next combination is a carry combination. So instead of writing 12, I will add 1 to it and write 13. Now 9 plus 8 is 17. End number is 7. But before writing 7, I see that the next one is a carry combination. So I will add 1 to 7 and write 8. Now 9 plus 3 is 12. But before writing 12, end number 2, I see that the next one is carry. So I write 2 plus 1, that is 3. Now 8 plus 6 is 14, but the next number is a carry number. So instead of writing 4 as an end number, I will write 5. And 9 plus 4 is 13, means end number 3. So this is our answer. I hope you have understood. Thanks for watching.